It had been 11 years since I last saw my aunt, who lives in Switzerland. I was going to be back in the city where she lived just for a few hours since I had a work meeting there. So I texted her via Facebook, taking the chance to invite her to come meet me up and catch up with each other's lives. After all these years, I had come of age and become my own woman, and I didn't even know if she would recognize me or reversely. I used to be close with my aunt until my mother and her had an incredible fight after my grandparents passed. And since then, Mom did everything she could to stop me from contacting Auntie. But as I got older and now made my own decisions, I took the risk and reached out to her. I was waiting outside the arrivals gate at the airport when I saw her approaching. I recognized her straight away from her dressing style that hadn't changed in ages, apparently. She wore the same glasses and sported the same messy hair as always. As I came up to her, hoping she would know who I was, I felt strangely happy, filled with faith and relief, and thrilled by the chance to revive a long-lost connection with my childhood idol. She truly used to be my everything, taking such great care of me when Mom wasn't around. When she finally saw me, she seemed upset, stressed, but she still welcomed me with a smile. "My darling," she exclaimed warmly, "look how much you've grown. Let me show you around town. I hope you have enough time on your hands. I'll tell you everything about what your auntie has been doing all these years," she continued without even letting me reply. We decided to take a bus to a nearby park, and as we got on, the driver asked us both for our IDs. I showed him my passport, but she hadn't brought hers, of course. The driver, upset, started dictating that she cannot stay on the bus if she didn't have a proper form of identification, which my aunt loudly contested. "Comment est-il possible? Je vis ici depuis 6 ans." "Come again," said the driver, half confused. "What is it that you don't understand?" "Je suis de nationalité suisse, monsieur," she said without trying to conceal her anger. "I do not speak French, madame." "How is that even possible? Laissez-moi passer." "I do not like to be screamed at, madame." "I'm only doing my job," he said calmly. "If you have a problem with the airport bus policy, then you should look for another means of transportation." My aunt violently grabbed my suitcase and sprinted out of the bus. "Come on, we'll go eat breakfast instead," she smiled to me as if nothing had happened. So we went back into the airport and found the quietest place, where we sat in the coldest of chairs and at the farthest of tables. It was a nice and cozy Spanish cafe. Waiters wore black suits, red ties. My aunt clapped her hands at the waiter, saying, "Hey you, come here and take our order." The whole restaurant could hear her shrieking voice. The waiter came to greet us despite her rudeness and asked, "So what would you like?" "I want 2 large black cafés glacés with no ice, 2 apple pastries lightly warmed, and a side of toast." As the waiter was carefully repeating her unusual order to make sure she got everything, my aunt interrupted him. "Don't you know how to do your job? No puedes escuchar la orden de una vez acaso?" she repeated in Spanish. By her tone, the waiter knew that she was being more difficult, but chose to reply politely. "I do not understand what you're saying, but..." "Do not tell me that you can't speak Spanish either!" She clapped her hands hysterically with a sarcastic laugh, indicating what she thought of everyone around, that they were all phonies. I was tired of my 16-hour trip, and I honestly didn't feel like Auntie was the same person I looked up to when I was a child. I wasn't happy, and the eye bags underneath my eyes told the whole story. Before we knew it, my flight was due to depart in 20 minutes. Auntie told me to at least get a takeaway meal, so we stayed at the restaurant waiting for my order at the grab-and-go counter, where I was handed a bocadillo. "Will that be all?" the cashier inquired respectfully. The feisty look in my aunt's face was almost scary. "Do you think we are going to spend any more money in a supposedly Spanish cafe where no one speaks the language? Shame on you." The cashier was boiling with exasperation. She threw my order on the counter for disrespecting customer employee policies. My aunt was given the full retribution she deserved. As we walked to my departure gate, I found myself lamenting the lost time. We didn't even have a chance to take a photo as a remembrance of a happy time. Once at my gate, my aunt got busy texting on her phone. She seemed indifferent to me leaving until I said goodbye, Aunt Mary. She smiled again and casually promised, "I swear on every ounce of life I have left in me that I'll make it up to you for all this mess. I assure you most people are smarter than what you've just witnessed back there," she said very optimistically. The last boarding call was announced, and I went on to catch up my flight. That was the last time I saw my aunt.
A bittersweet symphony.